Hi friends, let's study Article 11 of eUCP, Corruption of Electronic Record. A part. If an electronic record that has been received by the issuing bank, confirming bank or another nominated bank appears to have been corrupted, the bank may inform the presenter and may request that the electronic record be represented. This line seems to be simple, but there is a catch in it. I'll explain. I am an issuing bank. I have received a presentation from some negotiating bank or BENI and I am opening it for the first time. Now it appears to be corrupted. Then will I consider that the document is presented and tell the party that see it's corrupted and you represent it again? Will I do that or will I say that no, the document is not presented at all? So here comes Article E5 and F. An electronic record that cannot be authenticated is deemed not to have been presented. It means this will be the case that opening for the first time and the document cannot be opened. So it will mean that if the presentation period has expired, then it will mean that it's a late presentation. If I have opened the document earlier, I am the issuing bank and I have received the document earlier, I have opened it earlier and found correct. It was correct at that time, but now it has got corrupted. Now I am opening it, so found it corrupt. So then in that case E11, this article would apply. In the earlier case it won't apply. In the earlier case also I'll tell them to represent, but if for the first time it's not opening as per the documentation, then it's the presentation period has expired and those rules would apply. Now B part. If the bank requests that an electronic record be represented, then part number 1, the time for examination is suspended and resumes when the presenter represents the electronic record. Quite simple. Number 2, if a nominated bank is not a confirming bank, remember this, if it is a confirming bank then this won't apply. If it is not a confirming bank then only this would apply. So it must provide the issuing bank and any confirming bank with the notice of the request for representation. This means that the nominated bank has received a presentation from the BENI, but that file, and it has checked also, but it has that file has got corrupted. So that file, that bank will ask the BENI for representation, and that notice which it sends to the BENI, it will inform that notice to the issuing bank and the confirming bank and inform it of the suspension. It means it will inform the confirming bank or the issuing bank of the suspension period. Third, if the same electronic record is not represented within 30 calendar days, the bank may treat the electronic record as not presented. It means if the nominated bank or confirming bank or any bank has asked the BENI or the presenter to represent an electronic document, but that presenter has not represented it in 30 days, then that bank will treat the document as not presented. Last is, any of the deadlines are not extended, means that 30 days and any other days. What are these deadlines? The last presentation date or the expiry date. These need not be extended because of these corrupt documents. This again comes back to the first question which I had raised in this video. If the expiry date expires or presentation period expires due to the corrupt document being first presented, when first presented, then it is considered that it's not presented and deadlines need not be extended. But once you have checked it and then you have forwarded it or you have stored it and again you require for some purpose, then you will go back to that presenter. But in that case, once you have checked it and if he has not represented it in 30 days, then this article won't apply. That's a separate issue altogether other than this article. If somebody presents it for the first time and then it's corrupt and then you ask it for representation, he doesn't represent it in 30 days, then it will be treated as not presented. And the main point is none of the deadlines like expiry period etc. need to be extended. So you can download this YuGuru app from Play Store to get these videos, question banks, etc.